Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Engineering Today. And we're back with some interesting updates. These days, apart from Starlink launches, SpaceX is really busy preparing for the assembly of its beast rocket, Super Heavy. It's seen that the company is stacking up dozens of steel rings for Super Heavy's booster. SpaceX's CEO, Elon Musk, indicated the assembly process could be just a few weeks out. SpaceX's Super Heavy booster is assumed to be more than 70 meters or 230 feet tall, which is twice the height of the Starship's main propellant tank and engine section. Although a Super Heavy booster will not have a conical nose like SpaceX's SN8 Starship prototype, rather its entire body will be made of steel rings similar to Starship tanks. And once it will complete assembling all the parts, the whole booster will stand around the same size or even larger than the size of an entire two-stage Falcon 9 or Falcon Heavy rocket. Thus, it will be the tallest rocket among SpaceX's other boosters. According to sources, the steel rings, which will be used to build the Super Heavy booster, have a diameter around 9 meters, or 29 feet in length. It's 1.8 meters, or 6 feet tall. SpaceX's Super Heavy booster, to be specific, is divided into three major sections, which includes propellant tanks, interstage, and lastly, engine section. As per that, the company will need to stack a total of 38 steel rings to build the whole other structure. SpaceX is moving way more fast for the development of Super Heavy booster that it's created a problem for itself. SpaceX's test facility in High Bay, South Texas, where the components of the boosters are stacked up, is not as tall as the booster is. Thus, the assembly of the first booster will have to wait until the facility becomes tall enough to be ready to stack them. SpaceX is already on the work. A local photographer, Mary, also known as Boca Chica Gale, took some photos of SpaceX's Super Heavy booster. The photograph shows six sections of the Super Heavy booster, which have already been seen in Boca Chica. Another section of Super Heavy SN01 has been spotted. The stack is comprised of four rings and features a label saying LOX STACK 2, said by an individual who posted the photo on the 8th of October. He also asked, when will Super Heavy stacking commence? Which in reply, Musk said, High Bay should be finished, except for the giant gantry crane, within a few weeks. Super Heavy stacking should begin around then. Among six rings, two were spotted on September 22nd and 28th, and within October 7th, the other four rings were spotted. As per Musk's recent note, Super Heavy Booster's liquid oxygen tank will include longitudinal stiffeners, or more specifically, it's known as stringers. Stringers is nothing but a trio of five-ring stacks. We can expect that among those three five-ring stacks, one will be reserved for the first functional Starship nose section. Now the company's total 38 Super Heavy rings are waiting for the completion of high construction. In July 2020, SpaceX's team and its contractors first started building the High Bay. As per now, High Bay's construction work is going smoothly according to the plan. Regarding to that, Musk said the building is just a few weeks away from its completion. SpaceX's High Bay is around 80 meters or 262 feet tall with a gantry crane, which will stack the base rings one by one and give shape to the Super Heavy boosters as the final stage of production. The structure of the High Bay along with the building's roof is more or less complete, so is the wall cladding. Soon, contractors will start running the power. HVAC and plumbing will be done after that. SpaceX CEO previously said in a Twitter post, High Bay building is still a few weeks away, leaving the work of its giant gantry crane. However, it's expected that Super Heavy stacking process will begin even before that. Thus, there's a good chance that SpaceX will already start stacking Super Heavy subsections in their Starship mid-bay, and will add the remaining big stacks in High Bay to complete the booster assembly. It's well known that starting from the foundation of SpaceX, Elon Musk wanted to build a small human colony on Mars in the near future. He wants to provide planetary travel in a reliable and much cheaper way through the next generation Starships. To make it actually possible, a lot of traditional engineering challenges are involved that a company faces during its space journey. However, SpaceX's CEO, Elon Musk, knows how to face them with a creative manner that will entertain the crowd. With that same spirit, Musk recently pointed out the official Flag of Mars design. John Krause, a spaceflight photographer, shared a post on his Twitter page on this Thursday. Krause wrote, "An extensive piece for my Patreon supporters about capturing Falcon 9 transiting the sun on Tuesday. How I did it, some very candid thoughts on the photo's overwhelming reception, and why scrubs are a not fun but worthwhile part of the process." Followed by a photo of Falcon 9 with an orange sun in the background. With that reference, Krause was actually highlighting SpaceX's 13th Starlink launch, which just took place on Tuesday, October 6th. The popularity of that photo was enough to attract the CEO's attention. On Friday, Musk tweeted on that photo, "Maybe this should be the flag of Mars." SpaceX is making excellent progress, both on their Starlink program as well as on the Starship mission. The company also has several launch missions listed for the next year. The idea of Flag of Mars could be that Musk wants to encourage people to build an actual Martian flag, which could be used for the company's future travel to the Red Planet. Let's discuss news relating to Boeing now. Current Boeing employee Christopher Ferguson refused to command in Boeing's first crewed test flight. Christopher Ferguson, who is a Boeing employee and a former NASA astronaut, announced via a Twitter post that he is no longer in charge for the command of Boeing's new passenger spacecraft, the CST-100 Starliner, which is targeted to carry first human passengers by 2021. According to a recent information, current NASA astronaut Barry "Butch" Wilmore will now command Boeing's Starliner flight by replacing Ferguson's place. Wilmore will share his ride along with two other NASA astronauts that are already listed on the mission. As per Ferguson's video clip posted on Twitter, where he said leaving the flight was a difficult and personal decision that he had to make, "Next year is very important for my family," he said later in the video. "I've made several commitments which I simply cannot risk missing. I'm not going anywhere. I'm just not going into space next year." Ferguson has played an important role for the past few years in the development of Boeing's Starliner, which is a privately built crew capsule aimed to take astronauts to and from the International Space Station under NASA's crew mission. Ferguson, in his working days with NASA, commanded in a space shuttle in 2011, then the same year he was retired from the agency. After retirement, he started working with Boeing, and soon after that, he became the director for crew and mission systems in the Starliner program. In 2018, Ferguson was selected to command the first crewed Starliner flight test, along with astronauts Nicole Mann and Mike Finke as his fellow crewmates. Technically, Ferguson is not a NASA astronaut, thus he could have become the first private citizen to fly a privately made crewed spacecraft to the ISS. Ferguson wrote in his Twitter post, "I'm taking on a new mission, one that keeps my feet planted here firmly on Earth and prioritizes my most important crew, my family. I'll still be working hard with the hashtag Starliner team and the @NASA_astronauts on our crew." If all went according to the plan, we could have seen Starliner's first crewed launch earlier this year, although it was delayed due to a problem from last year. Last year, in December, Boeing launched its uncrewed Starliner on its debut flight to the International Space Station, but soon it was called back even before reaching the ISS due to several software glitches. Both the companies then performed a separate investigation. As per that, Boeing has been modifying its system with 80 recommendations to ensure that no more glitches occur on their upcoming flights. Now the company is ready to launch another uncrewed test flight of its Starliner spacecraft, currently scheduled for December 2020. After that, Boeing will launch its much-awaited first crewed test flight in June 2021. For that crewed launch, Wilmore is planning to start his training as soon as possible, along with his crewmates Mann and Finke. Meanwhile, Ferguson will still be in touch with Boeing's Starliner mission. As per Boeing, Ferguson might be allotted as the Director of Mission Integration and Operations, where he'll keep check on the astronauts' training to make sure it goes according to the plan and also support them during that time. The company stated that Ferguson would be included among the last people the crew will see before the launch and also one of the first they'll see after returning to Earth. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.